to implement queue, your linked list will look like this. There are two pointers into this linked list. One is front and another is rear. Insertion is done in the rear end because we know that queue is a linear data set in which insertion is done from the rear end, whereas deletion is done from the front end. So there are two pointers. One is rear and another is front. The rear pointer always points to the last element of the linked list, whereas the front pointer always points to the first element of the linked list. And the last element's next part is always null. Remember this thing. Last node's next part is always null. Instead of writing start, instead of writing top, now I am using another name to the head pointer, that is front. So front pointer always points to the front element of the queue, whereas rear pointer always points to the last element of the queue. Now, which functions we need to write, which code we need to write from implementation of singly linked list to insert a new node inside the queue? Inserting a value inside the queue is called enqueue operation. Inserting a value inside the queue is called as enqueue operation, right? And deleting the value from the queue is called as dequeue operation. Insertion is done at the rear end. It means that this code is similar to the implementation of inserting a new node at the last into the singly linked list. Inserting a new node at the last. So we can say it is insert last function. A code for insert last function is equivalent to enqueue operation into the queue. Implementation of queue using linked list. Similarly, another function we need to perform dequeue operation. Whenever you perform dequeue, the first element will be deleted and the front pointer is shifted from front to the immediate next element. So which function it is? Delete first. So this function is equal to delete first operation in singly linked list. So here we are going to use two codes. One is insert last in enqueue operation and delete first in dequeue operation. Okay, and remaining thing is as it is. In display operation, it displays all the elements of the queue from front pointer to the last element of the linked list. The elements are displayed in the same order in which they are inserted into the queue. So I'll directly go to the program now, because that theory part was already over in the theory lectures. I have given the file name as ql.c, means queue using linked list dot c. This program, check the code. Again, I am going to use the linked list for it. It means the first four file lines are same like previous program. There is a node structure which has two parts, information part and the next part. There are two pointers I need, that is front and rear. Front will point to the first element, whereas rear will going to point to the last element. Then P is to create a new node, Q is for traversing purpose. After creating that node structure, the next line in the code will be declaration of all the operations that you're going to perform on Q, that is enqueue, dequeue and display. So these are the three operations we are going to perform. Then we need to write the code for main program. What are we doing to the main program? The same thing that I have kept here that we did in implementation of queue using array. As soon as you enter into the main program, we declare a variable to store the option provided by the user operation that he wants to perform. Then clear screen will clear the screen, whereas front equal to rear equal to null tells the compiler that initially the queue is empty. So this is the line is very important, which tells the compiler that initially there is nothing inside the queue. Front equal to rear equals to null is the empty condition for queue using linked list. Then I have taken an infinite loop in that I am going to display menu card which has four options: enqueue, dequeue, display and exit. We'll take an option from the user, we store it into the ch variable and then we give it to the switch case. If the option one is entered, we execute enqueue function and we exit from the case one when it reaches break. In case two, we'll execute dequeue function. When it reaches break, we'll exit from case two. In case 3, we are going to execute display function. When it reaches break statement, we exit from case 3. In case 4, we are going to execute exit function to stop the program. And at last, there is a default statement which handles the errors of the switch case. If any other option is entered by the user apart from this available option 1, 2, 3, 4, the error message will be displayed on the screen that the entered choice is wrong or please enter a valid choice. Now, our major focus should be on the three functions, coding of three functions. One is NQ, another DQ, and third is display. So here, the definition of NQ function is written. Again, I am going to use linked list, so there is no overflow condition. Should be checked in the NQ operation. You can insert a number of elements inside the queue. So I will directly create a new node by this line p equal to malloc size of struct node. Then to fill the information part in the next part, I will use next three lines. One is I'm going to ask the user please enter the data, and I'll store that data into a p of info bar. Then I'll immediately assign p of x equal to null. So these four lines are standard, which will create a new node. The next line we're going to ask the user please enter the data. Third line we're going to store the information of the node. Data will be stored in the information part of the node. Fourth line is going to assign null value inside the next part of the new node created. Now, once the node is created, you need to first check underflow condition. If front equal to null, then we can say that there is nothing inside the queue. And the coming node is the only node available inside the queue. So I'll directly assign front pointer, rear pointer, both the pointers to newly created node, that is P. So I'll assign front equal to rear equal to P. Otherwise, suppose the front is not null, it means there are some elements inside the queue. I will assign rear of next. Means what is rear of next? It is rear pointer is always pointing to the last element. So I'm going to store the address of the newly created node in the next part of rear pointer, because I want to add a newly created node at the end of the linked list. And where is the end? End is pointed by rear pointer. So rear of next equal to p. And then I want to shift rear pointer from that last node to the newly created node, because now it is newly added inside the queue. So rear equal to rear of next. So these two lines are going to attach the last node of the queue to the newly created node, that is P. And then we are shifting rear pointer from that particular node, last node, to the newly created node by the line rear equal to rear of next. So this can be done n number of times. We can add n number of elements inside the queue. Then another function is display. It is very easy function. We'll take the help of queue pointer to start traversing inside the queue. Initially, front queue is equals to front. We'll check one condition, underflow condition. If queue equal to null, your queue is empty. Else, take a while loop and write a condition queue not equal to null. Till that point, you'll pick the information part and display it with the help of printf statement here. To go to the next node after displaying the information part, we'll use the line q equal to q of next. This while loop will end only when q becomes null. It means it displays all the elements of the queue from front to the last element in the same order in which the elements are inserted into the queue. The very important function is dq function. I want to delete a value from the queue. Always the front element will be deleted. So for that, I am using this queue pointer. Initially, that is pointing to the front. Then I'll check underflow condition. If q equal to null, there is nothing for deletion. We can't delete anything. Q is empty. Otherwise, I'll print the information part of the node. And then I'll shift front pointer from current location to the immediate next location. Because when you delete node, the second node becomes the front node, right? So this line will going to shift the front pointer to the second node. Then I'll assign q of next equal to null. When I assign q of next equal to null, the first node is completely isolated from the linked list. To free that node, I'll use free queue function to delete that node completely from the memory. Right. So this is for DQ option. I'm just changing the message here. Q is empty. Okay. Yes. Now I'll try to compile the program to check are there any errors or not into this program. no, there are no errors. Then to run the program, I'll use this menu. Yes, it is successfully executed, and the compiler is asking me to enter the choice. I'll put NQ operation. I want to do NQ operation, so I put one option. So the first value I inserted is 10. And next value I inserted is 20, again 1. I inserted the next value as 30, say. One more value I'm inserting, that is 40. So four elements have been inserted successfully. To check how the queue looks like, I'll use option number 3. Yes, it is showing me the queue locations. Queue has 10, 20, 30, and 40 value. All these values inside the queue. The first element is 10, and the lastly inserted element is 40. So it is showing me the elements in the same order in which they are inserted into the queue. The element which was inserted first was 10, then 20, then 30, and at last we inserted 40. So it is showing me the elements in the same order in which they inserted inside the queue. So the display function is working fine, as well as NQ function is working fine. Let me check about DQ function, working of DQ function. Now I'll put option number 2 to delete the first element. Yes, it is deleted successfully. Now we'll check the updated queue. Check now, 10 is not there in the updated queue. The updated queue has values 20, 30, and 40 into it. I'll apply DQ function again. 20 is deleted. Again, DQ operation, 30 is deleted. Now I'll check the updated queue. It has only one element remaining into it. I will again apply DQ function to delete that element. And I will just check using display operation, and now I can see my queue is empty. I will try to perform a DQ operation on empty queue. Let me check whether my program gives me an error or not. Yes, it is showing me an error that queue is empty. It means DQ function is also working fine. All functions, NQ, DQ, display functions are working fine. Now I want to stop the program. To stop the program, I will use option number 4. Yes. Are there any questions to